Hi there. Boy, this is going to be a fun night. George, you're not even here. You're in Boulder.
That's right. I'm in Boulder, Colorado tonight.
That's right. But we've got, this is going to be a broadcast that is coming from all over the place, a technological impossibility. We've got, Robert Marshall, and supposedly Rebekah Wilson is on a bus somewhere, but she's still going to try and be on the show from Source Elements. We're going to talk about Source Connect. We've got lots of other stuff, got a couple of questions that you guys have been sending in, which are fabulous. Any tech news this week, George, that we're going to be talking about? You'll find something,
I think the only
right?
tech news is that we got this show on the air.
Yes, all right. All this on Voice Over Body Shop. Stay right where you are. In the
two men, twin sons from different mothers, with a passion for voiceover recording technology and the desire to make recording easy for voiceover actors everywhere. Together, in one place, George Whittam, the home studio engineer to the stars, a Virginia Tech grad with an unmatched knowledge of all the latest gear and technology in voiceover today. Dan Leonard, the home studio master, a voiceover actor with over 30 years experience in broadcast and recording, and a no-holds-barred, myth-busting attitude for teaching you how easy it is. Together, finally, to bring you all the latest technology, the superstars of voiceover today, and leading the discussion on how to make the most of your voiceover business, this is VoiceOver Body Shop.
VoiceOver Body Shop is brought to you by VoiceOverEssentials.com, home of Harlan Hogan's signature products, Antland Productions, where you can get a killer demo, Source Elements, makers of Source Connect, Source Connect Pro, and Source Connect Now, VO2GoGo.com, and Rehearsal App, by VoiceOver Extra, your one-stop for voiceover success, Edge Studio, find your voice, and Busy Demos.
And now, live from their super secret multimedia studio in Sherman Oaks, California, here are George Whittam and Dan Leonard.
Keep your fingers crossed. All righty. I'm Dan Leonard.
And I'm George Whittam.
There's George Whittam. And this is VoiceOver
Body Shop.
Or VO.
BS.
Everybody, BS. All right. Well, oh, this is going to be an adventure tonight. We've got a great guest tonight. Robert Marshall and Rebekah Wilson from Source Elements are going to be joining us, hopefully in a little bit. We've got a couple of great questions coming from our audience out there that's sending questions. And guys, you can send in questions. We love hearing from you, the guys at VOBS.tv. And you're in Boulder, Colorado. How's the weather in Boulder?
It's beautiful. It is clear as a bell. And I'm here to celebrate Maxine Dunn's birthday. So we ordered up the perfect weather for her birthday.
And
it's been beautiful, but chilly. But for Colorado, it's actually perfect weather. This is what everybody likes. 40 during the day, 20 at night. It's gorgeous. Cool.
All right. Well, you'll notice the background here. You can cut off George's picture there for a second. See, the background here, I wanted, since you're in the mountains in Colorado, and I figured, well, let's just do a sort of a combination sort of thing. This is the mountains behind L.A., and you'll notice the palm trees and the snow. It does snow here. It's kind of cool.
I think it's a perfect mashup because I'm in the mountains and you're in L.A., so we have the mountains and the L.A. It's all there.
And the palm trees. It's everything. And that's what it's all about. So anyway, also, if you have a question, throw it in the chat room as well for our guests or for George and I, anything like, you know, on the spur of the moment. I know Anthony is in there in Kalamazoo, Michigan, in his brand new house. And he's going to be monitoring the chat room. And hopefully he can relay that stuff to us really quickly. Anyway,
I've got one more important announcement.
Oh, please.
But not only is it Maxine Dunn's birthday, it is my daughter Ella's birthday on the same day.
That's
right. And Ella turned 8 today. So everybody wish my daughter Ella a happy birthday, well, even though she's not on Facebook, and hopefully she isn't until she's 18.
Yes. But we also have surprise guests in here tonight as well.
And we have surprise guests.
Yeah, get the audience cam there, Andrew. There's
my parents.
Mr. and Mrs. Whittam, the parents of our illustrious co-host.
Hey, guys.
Yeah, okay.
They're visiting from Pennsylvania. They're in the chat room a lot. You guys who are in the regulars will know who they
are. Yes, and we're always happy to have them here. Now they're just chatting at us here in my room. Oh, and there goes my camera. Okay, we'll go to camera four. Okay.
We've got multiple camera backups.
Okay. All right. So anyway, so I've got to get the news here. But that camera is down. I'm good? Okay, good. Okay, well, in that case, it's time for...
And now, the VoiceOver Extra, VOBS News. The latest and most comprehensive VoiceOver industry news. Brought to you live.
For you guys to keep hanging out with us here tonight. All right, here's the news. VoiceOver Extra, VoiceOver rates... dropping? Are voiceover rates dropping this year, like faster than we've been accustomed to? Well, our VO pal Tom Deere, who's been on this very show, thinks they are, but says it's not easy to lay all the blame on one or two things. Agents, producers, ad agencies, lowball online casting, clients? Well, at least part of the blame could be our own. In a new VoiceOver Extra article, Tom explains how to negotiate a higher rate when a client's offer comes in a little lower than your fair quote. First, do your research. Rates are available from many sources, like SAG-AFTRA, input from colleagues and guides from VoiceOver training companies. If the client's offer matches within plus or minus 10%, well, great. But if the offer is lower, Tom advises not criticizing the bid directly. Instead, show the client your research results and source material so they can check it themselves. Some clients simply don't know the value of their project, so explain it to them objectively and, of course, diplomatically. You should always get paid your worth, says Tom. Of course, you might be tempted to take a low-paying job anyway, for instance, for a charity or a good cause, or getting in on the ground floor of a new venture, or maybe, but only maybe, if it's a new client. But be aware that you may never see that new client again. You know, oh yeah, we got lots of work for you. Anyway, you'll find more advice in this article now and hundreds more helpful articles on voiceoverextra.com, your daily resource for voiceover success. Success! Success. Anyway, so...
When I said that the tech news is the fact that we're on the air, do you want me to give a brief synopsis of what we're doing tonight to get everybody on the show?
I think that would be, you know, it'd be a lot more interesting than reading Ulysses. Go for it.
Well, what's going on is we use Zoom as a remote tool so that Dan, when he's out on the road, or if I'm on the road, or if any of our guests are traveling or coming from outside of the studio, we use Zoom. We use that as our multi-chat tool for the show, and it works reasonably well. Not only is it's not always super smooth, but it allows us to have multiple people on the show at the same time. So I'm coming in, as you guys know, from Boulder, Colorado. Robert is coming in from parts unknown, I believe Chicago area. I have his mic muted right now. Sorry, Robert. And then Rebekah is coming in from, she can disclose where she's coming in from, because I really don't know.
We'll figure that out
know.
When she gets here.
Yeah. And she could be in New Zealand for all we know. And then, so they're all being brought in to Dan's Mac Mini in the studio, which has its screen being remotely captured by the broadcast computer, which is what Andrew is operating using software called Wirecast. So that's all going on. That's the video side of things. We also have a video capture coming in from Dan's MacBook Air, so he can bring you Doll View 2017. That's coming up in the next segment. That's all going on. That's hard enough. Then there's the audio mix. We need an audio mix that goes out on the air. We need an audio mix for the people in the studio to hear. We need an audio mix for what the people on Zoom hear. And they have to all be different. So that is all being done by using our Behringer XR12 mixer. And the studio monitors are being controlled by our Allen & Heath XB10 console. And then the audio signal to and from Zoom is being handled by a Yamaha AG03. And all of it's working almost perfectly. We hear a little bit of echo, Robert and I, in our headphones. But otherwise, it's firing on pretty much on all cylinders. And I'm really happy we managed to pull it off for you guys tonight. So I won't bore you anymore, but some of you geeks out there I thought might enjoy knowing what it is we're doing to bring you the show tonight.
Okay, no, we had no audio. You have to explain that again. No, no, just kidding. Just kidding.
Nice one.
All right. Well, okay, well, lots of cool stuff going on tonight. Again, you got a question, throw it in the chat room. You have a comment. If it's nasty, keep it to yourself. But we'll be talking with Robert Marshall and Rebekah Wilson from Source Connect. And Source Connect is fascinating stuff. We'll get a little bit more about their history and what they're doing now. So that ought to be really cool. So we've got your questions coming up right after this message. So do not go away.
Hiya, VO friends. You say you ain't booked a VO gig in 7 years? And your demo is so old that you can hear the clicks from the stock music records? And you hear so much tape hiss that you run to the sink to see if the faucet is running? And the engineer used so much echo on your voice that it sounds like it was recorded in the Grand Canyon? And the scripts seem a bit dated too, advertising the new and improved 1938 Plymouth Road King? Is that what's been troubling you, Bunky?
We lift your head up high and take a walk in the sun. Your demo can be killer, too. Just contact Uncle Roy at atlandproductions.com and book yourself a shiny new killer demo. Show your stick-to-itiveness and show the world you'll never give up, never give up, never give up that dream.
You're listening to VOBS.
VoiceOver Body Shop. Learn the latest in voiceover technology. Learn how to get rid of that. VoiceOver Body Shop, 9 Eastern, 6 Pacific, on VOBS.us.
Well, I'm here to tell you guys about our wonderful sponsor, Source Elements. And they're not just wonderful because they're here tonight on the show. They're wonderful because they create an amazing software utility that allows folks out there to connect to other studios real time with really, really high quality audio. And there's a few really key features, and we're going to expound upon this later, so I won't spend a ton of time on it now telling you all the features of Source Connect. But Source Connect allows you to have complete control over things like latency, so you can control how reliable the connection is versus how easy it is to communicate with somebody in a natural conversation. It lets you have control over the audio sources that are going in and out of the software. And it uses licensing on an iLock, so you can carry it from computer to computer. But the key thing is it allows studios to bring your audio directly into Pro Tools, which is really important to recording studios around the world to be able to do that. And it does it beautifully. If you want to give it a 15-day free trial, go to source-elements.com. and sign up. You can give it a shot right away and give it a try and let us know what you think and let them know we sent you, because we want you to know that we want them to know where they heard about us. So thanks for watching, and we'll be right back with Doll View 2017 after this break.
Are we at minus 4 dB? We're at minus 4 dB on VOBS.
Learn the latest in voiceover technology.
Business.
And good old-fashioned acting.
Hey, Paul, I really like your suit. Where did you get it? It looks good on you.
This is VOBS.
And God willing, we're back here on VoiceOver Body Shop. Well, we've got... I forgot to mention one other thing. We have a new mug man tonight. All right. Jacob has been studying away at Exceptional Mind Studio, and you'll see how his style of animation has completely changed. So stay tuned right after the show for that, a quick little short that he did that he was working on. Anyway, we've got your questions. and we're going to be using DAWVIEW 2017. So roll the DAWVIEW 2017 theme there, Andrew.
DAWVIEW 2017.
It was worth it just for that. Anyway, okay, our first question tonight comes from Kate Galineau. For whatever reason, my audio is coming in extremely low. When I normalize it in Audacity, it's back where it should be. But why can't I get my audio volume higher without normalizing? All right, well, she says she's checked all the ports and inputs and everything's fine. There are a few pictures on her Instagram to show her basic setup. Now, she's got your typical setup, your basic interface and all that kind of stuff. First, why would your input be low? Chances are we need to really see all the settings to see why that would be happening. There's a number of reasons. The number one reason, of course, in my book is that you're on a PC. And that usually is what causes these problems. In a Mac, if you've got low input, it's usually very easy to quickly go back and see, okay, everything's here. Okay, this should be fine. And then you make sure it's going right through the interface. On a PC, sometimes, as George and I will tell you quite often, it doesn't like audio very much and decides itself what it wants. And sometimes we'll change inputs, or sometimes a special effect might be clicked or something like that. And how often do you see that, George?
It happens quite a lot. I mean, each new Windows version introduces new little bugaboos. I installed, I got a Windows 10 device recently. It's called an Intel Compute Stick. And in my very basic testing, everything seemed to work okay. But if you're using audio hardware that has its own drivers, that's where things get a little hairy. And so if the drivers weren't written correctly for Windows 10, completely written for Windows 10 specifically, there may be issues. And so the audio hardware you're using might be part of that problem. Dan, tell me again what audio hardware she said she's using.
She's using, now I can't remember which it is. So one of those things that just got lost during all the other chaos, but...
it's not in the email. It's not in a question, is it?
No, but it is in the email. Let me check the email real quick here.
Okay. That's an important distinction. But probably part of the issue here really is just the fact that there's an audio driver issue. And one of the things we find that fixes it most often in Windows 10 is to re-download and install the correct driver for your audio hardware. That fixes most of the problems we've seen to date.
Yeah. But
so I'd start there.
Okay. Well, cool. Well, yeah. And it's important to really go through your settings pretty, I can't really show you on my Mac because we don't use PCs here to demonstrate that. How to check your levels and stuff.
There's also issues with which audio driver do you choose to use on your Windows software, whatever it is, because you sometimes have more than one option. Sometimes you have Windows Classic Wave Driver or MME, and sometimes you have something called ASIO, and you might try a different driver setting in Audacity. Now, I don't know if Audacity supports ASIO, so that might be be irrelevant to you, but sometimes changing that audio driver setting in your DAW can clear up an issue. The reason why ASIO can be better than the Windows Classic Wave Driver or MME is because with ASIO, there's more of a direct link between the audio hardware's driver and everything and the DAW that you're using. It's not going through the Windows audio control panel. So if you have access to an ASIO driver, sometimes that clears up problems. Other times it creates new problems. So again, drivers.
Yeah. Of course, now this usually solves the problem right here. And that's a Mac because it doesn't have any of those problems. You know, I mean, it's just for audio, George. It's just, if you're doing calculations, if you are predicting global warming or climate change or a tsunami coming, PCs are great at crunching numbers. But Macs are really good with audio. But
I will say there's a a little bit of a movement right now where there's a little bit of an Apple backlash. There's been an Apple backlash since Apple was Apple, but I mean, there's been an Apple backlash because of the newest computers coming out are not like amazing. They're not these huge improvements in power and horsepower. And the top of the line Macs are not what you can get in the Windows side in terms of pure power. That doesn't matter for voice acting. What matters for us as voice actors is something that's extremely reliable, simple to operate, and just something you know you can count on. And I'm not going to say Apple's perfect, because if you have your system upgrading automatically to new operating systems, hey, you're going to cause your own problems. So it's not just a panacea because you're on Apple, but just because of our tremendous amount of time supporting so many people, I can tell you in general, Apple is a lot less problematic to deal with. So that's why we kind of tend to harp on it.
Right. And that's why I said that. Okay. I want to now her thing was, is the initial part of her question was, is, you know, my audio input is low. So I normalize it. So we're going to go to DAWView 2017 here. I love how this works.
Wow.
Yeah. Isn't that something? Okay. Well, yeah, I know. So here's what, this is what low audio looks like. It's supposed to look like that, my friends. But what she's getting is this, and she's saying what she's doing is she's normalizing her audio. Now, what does normalization do? Normalization will raise the overall audio level to a peak level that you set, which we generally like to use is -3. Now, in Twisted Wave here, which is, you know, it does the same thing in Audacity. There's a button here that just does the normalization. And here's what happens. Set it to -3, boom. And suddenly it looks right. But the problem is when you normalize a really low signal, you are going to be raising the noise level of your file, because the signal to noise ratio isn't good. Your signal is very low, and when you raise it up, you're going to create a lot of noise in the background. Plus, any physical noise that was in the background is going to be louder. So we recommend you, if you're going to normalize, you have to get your audio level right in the first place. So if your level should be like this to start with, and then you can, now if I normalize this, and this was just recorded me talking into my Mac Air here. And if I hit normalize with this, watch what happens. Nothing, because it was recorded right in the first place. So don't use normalize until you have finished all your processing, which should be minimal. Our good friend Uncle Roy likes to say, normalize after you do all your processing, normalize again. But it should be a tiny, tiny little adjustment. It might even be an adjustment down. You don't even realize it by using normalization. So
that's right.
That's my little primer on normalization. Any other thoughts, George?
No, it's a really great little tweak to ensure proper processing. It should not be used as a crutch to correct really low levels, but it's a great way to just make a small adjustment so that if you're going to do processing, the processing works consistently.
All righty. Well, that's our discussion and your answers tonight. We had another question here from Paul Lineweber. We talked about a noise gate last week, and I'll give her a quick answer about this. Would that be something I could use to eliminate the hum I keep getting from not one, but two refrigerators? Seems like one or the other is almost always running, and the second one is upstairs in the kitchen, physically impossible to turn off. Well, you just got to pull it out and unplug it. Just got to remember to plug it back in and push it back against the wall. So when I heard George mention a noise gate, I thought maybe that might be the answer. Let me know what you think about that. And if so, how does it work and how do I use it? Well, we talked about a noise gate last week. But if you've got a hum, a physical hum, it depends on how loud it is. If you've got a hum that is louder than, say, -50 dB.
-50, yeah.
You're going to hear it. And even no matter how well you set the noise gate. So we don't really recommend that for if you've got a noise like that.
Yeah. So a noise like that, a noise gate is okay with maybe white noise or a broadband noise. you know, a noise that's just very soft, but it's consistent all the way through.
Right.
That kind of sound isn't that noticeable when you're actually talking. So the gate opens as soon as you start talking. You know, it allows your signal, your voice to pass through. But a sound like a hum, assuming you're talking about a hum, not a buzz, something like that, a hum, that signal or that waveform, that garbage is going to be visible and audible whether the gate is, you know, when the gate is open. And that's when you're talking. And so it's still going to be detectable. So a better tool for a hum is usually what's called an equalizer, a specific kind of equalizer called a parametric equalizer. And if you're using something like Isotope, they have a de-humming feature. And I believe also Akon Digital has a de-humming feature. And these are just filters that are designed to remove humming tones from the audio.
Right.
So that's a better way to go. Find out what frequency it is and then filter out that frequency alone if you can. That seems to work better in most cases, I've found.
Yeah. And that takes a little bit of practice and a little bit of skill and understanding,
yeah.
Frequencies and stuff like that. But that's why we're here, to teach you that stuff. Anyway, Robert Marshall, Rebekah Wilson are standing by in various parts of the globe to talk to us here on VoiceOver Body Shop, and we'll get to them right after these messages.
In a world of audio, two men knew what they were doing, or at least they have you convinced. They put the BS in VOBS.TV.
Are you confused about how to set up and maintain a professional quality voiceover studio? No wonder. The information out there is mostly mythology. This is the best microphone to use. You have to have a preamp. You need a soundproof booth. This software is the best. Your audio must be broadcast quality. Consult with someone who knows the truth. Someone who's been there, in the trenches, doing voiceover for over 30 years. Someone with unparalleled experience with voiceover studios, who's worked with hundreds of voice actors and designed hundreds of personal studios. He knows how to teach and cares about your success in one of the harshest environments known to voiceover, your home. Dan Leonard, the Home Studio Master. Separate myth from fact and get a handle on your personal voiceover studio. Contact the Home Studio Master at homevoiceoverstudio.com. Drop off a specimen of your dry audio for a free analysis.
Talking so you don't hear that.
Hey, you want to know something? Now is a great time to get Rehearsal Pro, because in just a few short weeks, there's going to be a brand new feature in Rehearsal Pro that will blow you away. We're going to give you access to a new community of actors and voice talent where you can offer your services as a professional to help others with their rehearsing and scene exploration. More details coming very soon. Now, Rehearsal Pro, the app for actors and voiceover talent, is available now at rehearsal.pro/download. That's rehearsal.pro/download. Learning your lines for on-camera work has never been easier, and creating quick, awesome-sounding VO auditions has never been faster. And with the new Reader Marketplace, you'll be able to create your own business helping other actors book more work. Sounds like a great thing to me. That is Rehearsal Pro, available at rehearsal.pro/download. That's rehearsal.pro/download. And it's so easy. It's just right here on your phone. It's just right there, right on your phone. And it helps you learn your lines. Go get it. All right. Source Elements, folks, coming up from all sorts of places in a minute.
You're competing for work with other voice talents, and every one of them has a powerful, unique, engaging voice demo. Your voice demo needs to stand out from the crowd in an unforgettable way. Now it can. Vizzy Visual Voice Demos. Take your awesome voice demo and add a visual element, reinforcing your brand. Your demo will leave a lasting impression because it stimulates two senses instead of just one. Your voice is your livelihood. You need an effective demo to open doors of opportunity. Blow those doors down with a Vizzy visual voice demo. Visit VizzyDemos.com for more information. Your audio demo never looked so good. Take your voice demos to the next level, a visual level, with Vizzy visual voice demos. Check out our introductory pricing at VO Atlanta 2017.
All right, we are back here on VoiceOver Body Shop. Yeah, we're going to be at VO Atlanta. I know Gerald is out there watching. You know, it's going to be a great, great time. Everybody who is in VoiceOver is going to be there. Everybody, including us. Anyway, should be
fun.
That's
right.
Can't wait to get on the plane with George, and we're just going to have a party for about 5 days, and it's going to be lots of fun. Anyway, it's time to welcome our guests. Robert Marshall. Hi, Robert. How you doing?
You're going to be on mute, Tim. Go ahead, Robert.
Hello. Thank you.
Nice. Where are you joining us from tonight?
Chicago.
Wonderful town. And joining us also, I believe, do we just have audio with Rebecca?
I should have video here.
Okay. And we also have Rebecca Wilson. Oh, my goodness. It is bright sunshine because Rebecca is in New Zealand. All right.
Good afternoon.
It might be the farthest distant thing that we've done here on the show. We've had China on the show. I think we've had New Zealand before and Australia. But Rebecca, thank you so much for joining us today.
Oh, it's a pleasure.
Now, you guys are with this company, Source Elements. You are the creators of Source Connect, Source Connect Pro, Source Connect Now, Source Connect Source Direct.
Source Live.
I mean, there are just so many products you've got there. First, tell us a little bit of background about yourself, starting with Robert. How did you get into this business?
Oh, boy. Into audio?
Yeah.
that started in high school. I got out of college with a degree in music composition and ended up eventually doing post-production, sound design, mixing, and at the studio I was working at, we were doing a lot of ISDN connections. And so part of that was also the internet was coming of age at that point and kept on going, why do we have to do this over ISDN? Why not the internet? And so we spawned Source Elements out of the post house I was working at the time. And that was 15 years ago, it seems.
Remember it well.
Yeah.
Yeah. Rebecca, what about you? How did you find yourself doing this?
Oh, that's Robert's fault.
and he's probably perfectly willing to
take my job in Europe and was slowly touring my way back to New Zealand and then end up stuck in Chicago. It's absolutely Robert's fault.
But what's your background?
I don't know why I stayed. The winters are the worst. And I've lived in Montreal and I still think Chicago's worse.
Oh, yeah, well, yeah, Montreal, yeah. Chicago, pretty much the same, really, when it comes to the wind and stuff. So how did you get into this type of, you know, what's your background? How did you get into, the technical end of all this?
I also have a degree in music composition and electronics, so Robert and I have very similar backgrounds.
Ah, okay, that makes sense.
But she's much smarter than me when it comes to programming, so she, Rebecca is definitely the technical half in many aspects of how Source Elements was put together.
I disagree there, but Robert's being humble.
Okay, you two argue amongst yourselves.
That's so, fine. Yeah.
So what? Tell us a little bit more about the history of the company. And you started it 15 years ago, and what was your original intention with it, and how's that going?
The original intention was we were faced with really huge ISDN bills, and it seemed like a smarter thing to do this all over the internet, which had more bandwidth, and it was a big education to learn about, you know, what bandwidth really is and the consistency of it. And even though you have more, is it really as good as the bandwidth that ISDN provides? But so really it started out as trying to create a tool that was better for our purposes at the in our post operation, and took off from there, really.
Oh, nope.
It was probably around the same time. Actually, I believe that Source Connect was released. I'm reading him. The same time that Skype was released.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. We're just not hearing you quite as well here for some reason, but I can hear you.
I'm playing with the mix. Sorry, guys.
Oh, it's George's fault.
Live mixing is dangerous.
Yes,
it is.
George is the master of that. So now the voiceover community is a fascinating community. I mean, I'm sure that photographers talk to each other, and I'm sure that, you know, many other types of professions talk to each other. But the voiceover community is kind of special. Do you guys find working with the voiceover community a real interesting experience?
No, I just love the vibrancy of the community. It's something I was telling Robert the other day, that we know the honesty and vibrancy, specifically because the tools have to work. There's no opinion about how it works or it doesn't, and that makes it really exciting for us, and also easier in a way, because you're not meeting, you know, Photoshop filters, which I think that looks good. It's really specific. It's like, does that audio sound good? And we like the specificness of that. Thanks.
Yeah, I think also it's fun just working with voiceover people, because they are, many of them are actors and such characters, and so there's a lot of interesting and fun people in the industry as well. So
I think we've made real friends over these years.
Yeah,
I'll tell you, actors are a totally different audience to work with, or audience or client base to work with, than engineers. Just to interject, I mean, that's what I love. Because I'm also someone who's serving a technical service to actors like you guys, and that's what's so great about working with the actors. Yeah. It's a totally different perspective. They have a very creative brain. I always forget, is it the left brain? The actors are more left brain.
Yeah, it's the right brain guys who can do the math.
Thank you. Yeah, right brain is the math. It's so you have to think from their perspective, and I think that's the unique challenge of serving the acting community. These tools, and that's what I feel like I want to thrive on. And I've been working, and I've known Rebekah and Robert for 8-9 years now.
Yeah, I mean, you were one of the first dealers for Source Connect, and really, yeah, I mean, first one to dig in, and also really start working with voiceover people very directly. I mean, when we first started, I mean, our initial sales were mainly studios to studios, and a lot of the times and really, this is the type of thing that I believe that Source Connect has really created even more of an opportunity for. So, you know, when we first started out, we were doing 90% of the connections were studio to studio, ISDN to ISDN, and then we came out with Source Connect, and it was, okay, ISDN or Source Connect, and eventually, more and more, you know, every now and then you'd hook up with a voice talent who had ISDN at their house, but they were these guys that were just cranking out sessions every day. They were too busy to go to a studio. And then, you know, as tools like Source Connect have come out, and especially when we put out the standard version, it really began filtering more out to the wider voiceover community. And that's really where you introduced it a lot to that community.
Well, it allowed for once, talent some freedom, because we know in voiceover, you get these golden handcuffs. Yeah, you can make a really good living, but you sacrifice a lot to make that good living. You just are chained to a studio.
That
all of us know somebody, or we are somebody who has that problem.
It totally reminds me of, you know, Joseph Briano, who within a year or not even of us releasing this, Joe found it. He's calling us up. He's trying it out. He knew exactly what it could do for him, which was free him from his studio. In fact, I remember, I mean, one of the first sort of, not really a bug, but one of the things you have to solve when you make these things is Source Connect sample rate converts. And so I connected with Joe, and he's at 44.1. I'm at 48, and he's sounding like a chipmunk. And he's like, oh, should put a sample rate converter in this thing too. but yeah, I mean, he was like one of these guys that had ISDN in his house, but was looking for something else to free himself of that, so that he could travel. And he's the king of using this thing from hotel rooms and the back of a car. I mean, you name it.
Yeah, it's the users that drive forward progress of software like this at the end of the day, right? I mean, you guys are always innovating with new ideas, but at the end of the day, you listen to what the users need. And, you know, you can make certain assumptions that an engineer will make because, you know, you're an engineer, you think like an engineer, and you think, well, an engineer would know to match sample rates. But a talent, sample rate?
What is that?
How would I even change that, right? So just to be able to implement that stuff is awesome. Dan, are we still getting coming through 5x5?
Yeah, pretty much. We're stretching the internet probably a little bit more than usual tonight. But
well, that's what's so interesting about this show tonight is Robert and I are on Zoom and you're on something else. So he and I have a better connection. We can kind of just sort of have our own conversation and forget the studio back in Los Angeles. But no, it's been great to kind of be a part of this with you guys on, you know, sort of a behind the scenes kind of level of just helping to give some notes as to what voice actors need and want, you know. And I love that aspect about Source Elements as a company.
Yeah,
it's also really fulfilling, like, providing this tool that people are like, you know, literally thank you so much, and having that interaction with people beyond just their fun, but they're also often very grateful, and that's well received.
Yeah. Now, you've got a lot of different products there that, you know, that I mentioned. You know, we could probably go through the alphabet soup of all the different things that Source Elements offers. What are the different lines, and what is different about each of them?
Sure, I can. So you have, I'll start at the very top version, which no one in this blog or in this community here needs, but I'll go over it. So Source Connect Pro X, that is basically does 5.1 and 7.1 connections, studio to studio. It can do also stereo and all that. And then you have Source Connect Pro, which is really intended to be on the studio side of the connection, so the connection doing the recording. It has you know, various features such as it can do the restore and the replace modes, so that it guarantees that the recording is good regardless of the bandwidth. And then you have Source Connect Standard, which is intended to be on the you know, mainly the talent or the voice talent side of the connection. And so those are the three main sort of software. They run on Mac and PC for the most part. You know, definitely Source Connect Standard and Source Connect Pro run on Mac and PC. Source Connect Pro X is Mac only. Those all connect with each other. And then we also have Source Connect Now, which is a free service, currently fully free. It's always going to have a free tier to it. And as of this moment, it's really an island onto itself. So Source Connect Now connects to Source Connect Now, or anybody can connect in as a guest on Source Connect Now. So it runs on the Chrome web browser, and, you know, it's an excellent run and gun tool. It provides very good audio quality in the cases where the bandwidth is there, but some of the issues with Chrome come down to really what's behind it. And, so I would call Source Connect Now more of an implementation than a complete standalone software. It's using communication tools, you know, built into Chrome. And those tools were, in a sense, designed to let you talk to grandma. And it doesn't handle audio with the same kid gloves that Source Connect does. It doesn't handle latency in the same way. It doesn't sort of deal with bandwidth issues in the same way. So it's possible that it introduces various distortions. But that being said, it's so easy to set up. Chrome is everywhere. So it's a great tool. You know, I can't think of one situation where you wouldn't use it instead of a phone patch. That's for sure.
Yeah.
It's definitely ubiquitous, right?
Yeah. Chrome. Well, I have to say that I used Source Connect to cut my demo with our good friend Cliff Zellman, who was in Dallas. And we tried a couple of other things. We went to Source Connect Now. It worked fabulous, and my demo came out really well. It's, you know, you can go at a high bandwidth, but most importantly, aside from the fact that you can communicate back and forth, the ability to record in your own studio and have those original files is also really nice. So if they're recording on their end, they're recording on their end, but you're also recording on your end. So it's sort of a fail-safe sort of thing. So and Source Connect now is free, right?
Yeah, it's fully free right now. It's something that we're constantly building, and eventually that knot will be tied where it connects actually directly back into the Source Connect software itself. Like I said, right now it's an island where it only connects to Chrome, so it's Chrome to Chrome, but eventually it'll be Chrome to Source Connect. But some of the, like, you know, you were mentioning being able to record yourself and have a backup of it. And we make so many other tools besides just Source Connect. So for instance, one of the things that people love about Source Connect, and this gets a little bit more onto the studio side, which is, the guys doing the recording of the talent, is that it directly integrates right into Pro Tools or any workstation via a plugin. And so it makes it very easy to integrate. And to that end, we also make Source Nexus, which is a plugin that basically turns any application into a plugin. So you can therefore take Chrome and put it, get it to send and receive directly with Pro Tools or Audition or Logic or whatever workstation, you're using at the time. So it begins to bring those types of features that Source Connect has over to the Chrome environment. And really opens up sort of what we call inter-application routing. So you can have, for instance, a connection on Source Connect. At the same time, you can have a patch going to a client on Source Connect now, and all of these things that would normally require a patch bay and a mixer, and it's all happening just in your laptop without having to have any cables.
Yeah, I think that's probably one of the best things about it. You know, having worked in a radio station and being told, don't go near the patch bay, don't touch any of those things. Just patching, through Source Connect is, for some, it can be a little challenging. That's why they call George, because they can organize that. But within your laptop, that's such a leap forward. And it made it real super simple for a lot of people.
For sure. Yeah. And then when you, once you really get into Source Connect, there's so many things that, I feel that it does that, they don't get used every day, but for instance, once you're in your workstation, it's possible for the client to send you a picture, have that picture in your workstation, and then you could read with picture sync on both sides so that you're hitting all those cue points and you know your timing exactly. And the engineers on the record side are controlling your transport. So all you have to do is look at picture and, depending on what type of spot you're doing, if you're calling out price points and hitting with certain cues, you can really do that live, or things, where they're doing promos for next on Fox, this and that. And then they have a little bit of audio jump in from the next TV show. Those are all things you can do. They're really, take it to the next level, essentially, and really integrate it directly into the studio environment.
Yeah, which is really more than what you can do on ISDN, because there it's just completely auditory. And now with video, it's like you're almost like in the studio with them.
Yeah, I mean, to do that same thing with ISDN would have required, and that's the way they did it, but it would have required hooking up in stereo, which meant you would have lost half your audio quality. You would have been at 64K, which is really, at that point, audibly bad. Then having timecode generators and timecode readers on either side of the connection. And at that point, it's something that's, not for the faint of heart.
Yeah.
Well, so, mentioning the, working to picture aspect, I mean, you can sort of quasi cobble together that sort of capability using other systems, but the way Source Connect does it is so well integrated. And the other thing that's key to the fact that it's not using Chrome, and Robert alluded to this earlier, is that it will maintain frame lock, and it's sample to sample sync lock. Is that right, Robert?
That's absolutely right, because that's, first of all, one of the things that the restore and replace system relies on is that, so with Source Connect, if you're recording and there is a dropout that occurs, you do take one, take two has a dropout because of some internet happening, take three, take four, you go back to play take two that had the dropout, and basically Source Connect went in there and fitted in all the missing audio that didn't arrive in real time. And the only way that that can happen is if the time factor doesn't change, which is immediately where the more consumer-oriented tools start getting into they're more interested in preserving what they consider intelligibility. They're trying to provide a system that is built for a conversation. And so if it needs to, you know, I'm sure many people have been on Skype, and Chrome does the same thing, where if it runs into a bandwidth problem, it starts stretching audio. And then after that goes really quick to catch back up.
Like that.
Right. And so if you're the audio engineer and you do that and you've recorded these takes, first of all, you don't know if you're just reading it weird as a talent, or if not, and it's so bad that it clearly is unnaturally sped up. Now you can't edit things and then later get the final takes and have them fit back into the edits that you did already. So those are things where, yeah, Source Connect basically keeps perfect sync. In fact, it has a fixed buffer mode, but it really doesn't change its buffer once it connects. It has a fixed latency, and that is key for doing things like picture lock and the replace system and all those types of things, which is the same thing that ISDN would have done as well.
All righty. If anybody's got a question for Robert Marshall from Source Elements, I take it we've lost Rebekah.
I see her.
Oh,
back
there she
on.
Is. She's
yeah,
back.
There she is. Yeah.
Okay. If we have a question for our friends from Source Elements, throw them in the chat room. I know Anthony is taking them down. We got a few already, and we'll get to those in just a little bit. You guys have anything new coming up? I mean, it seems like there's always something new coming out of the Source Elements labs.
We have a lot of new things. Some of them we can't really talk about until they're released. We hate vaporware, so we just won't release vaporware. But we have a lot of exciting things that will be coming up, and we would love to talk about that. But you know, new features in Source Connect 3.9 that have been really key. One of them is a new feature called Source Stream. So when you look at what Source Connect does when it has to create a connection, is you know, typically, and one of the hardest things has been dealing with port situations. So if your router doesn't have an open port, the next thing that Source Connect has to do is basically, you know, in a sense, kick down the doors of your router and get its way through on its own means. And in the past, if it couldn't get through that way, it would eventually had the possibility, if you didn't have an open port, of literally not, like, one side wasn't receiving audio. And so the new feature with Source Stream is that instead of just giving up at the point where it has no port and it can't kick down the firewall, it will then pass all the data across our servers. And it all but guarantees that those connections will be made. It's technically not as efficient as a direct peer-to-peer connection, but in a situation where maybe you're at a hotel and you know, you're not going to be able to call the front desk and say, open up a pair of ports, please. That's the kind of system that, you know, you need in place so that no matter where you are, you can get through. And you don't have to worry about those technical things that are going to possibly throw a wrench in your session. The other feature we have that's, I'll talk about it now, it's just about to be released, is SourceNet. And so what this is a feature where it lets you use two internet connections simultaneously. So it gets you to the cloud in a very robust manner. The theory here, or the idea, is that no two internet service providers would drop the same packet at the same time, statistically very low. So it having two connections doesn't just increase your reliability by 50%, but much more than 50%. So if two people have, both users are using SourceNet on both sides, then you have basically a completely real-time redundant connection end-to-end, which affords you something, a much more reliable connection, and that might give you the opportunity to drop those buffers way down and have a really, really low latency connection while still being extremely reliable. So those are two new things right there with Source Connect 3.9.
I got a question for Rebekah, since you're back, Rebekah. Robert is the sort of the audio brain. You're more of the coding brain. Am I right about that?
Oh no, I don't hear her.
Is she muted?
No, check your audio input setting, Rebekah.
Check your ASIO driver.
No, it's her MME.
It's
no,
a Mac.
She's not muted. She just, her internal sound might be muted, but she's not muted on Zoom.
Okay, well, I'll answer this and she'll hate me for it, but yes, she is definitely the coding brain. So I can go to Rebekah and say, I think that we need a plugin that looks like this, and it should interface to Pro Tools like this. And Source Connect, by the way, works not just with Pro Tools. This is a huge myth out there that it's a Pro Tools plugin. It's a VST AU, RTAS, AAX, and standalone application for Mac and Windows. It pretty much works on all computing systems and all workstations. And so, Rebekah,
there she is.
I'll shut up now. You said keep you like going?
okay no
so nothing would happen without Rebekah is the point.
No, Rebekah, I would say I'm just the interface between Robert's brain and the rest of the world in terms of programming.
So Robert comes at you, Rebekah, with like wish lists, like I want to be able to do this, I want to be able to do that, and you're the one that says
he has a particular ability to see into the future when it comes to audio tech. It's quite remarkable. I've always admired it.
Thank you.
So it's a tough job, right? Because Rebekah, you're basically the one who's saying yes, but, or no.
It always turns out a week later, all right, I thought about it and it's possible. I hate you.
I think a fun one is how we came up with the remote transport sync system. And so, you know, the first thing was, okay, I want to be able to lock up the two systems and I don't want to have to go through the hassle of sending time code back and forth and having generators and hardware to do that. And I had a slight idea, which was, you know, I can lock two systems together within the laptop. And so I said, you know, how about we use Rewire? And I don't think it was Rebekah, but, you know, with various people within the company who are writing the code, and they're like, well, that's not what Rewire is for. It's to lock two programs up that are inside the same computer. And I was just like, well, why? why can't they be on either side of the world? And so it's fun to push things where they're not supposed to go and then see. But you do get, of course, there's a lot of, you know, times where the answer is not that it it's not no, it's just that's tough or that'll take a lot of time or that would be really expensive.
Yeah.
Right.
But Rebekah can make it happen.
Well, it's good to know. But you look great, Rebekah. Don't worry about it. You sound great. You look great.
That's what's important.
We're going to take a break right now. If you've got a question for Robert Marshall or Rebekah Wilson from Source Elements, the makers of Source Connect and all those other things that they do, get them in there so Anthony can get them to us. And we'll be right back after this message. So do not go away.
Learning never ends.
You continue to grow.
Edge Studio has grown. Pursue multiple disciplines in tandem and grow your career. We've added new courses in a new curriculum.
We picked the best coaches from the community of working voice actors.
A new technology division, engineering and consulting, led by George Whittam.
Follow your dream.
Sign up for advanced learning or register for an introduction to voice acting or foundation studies program.
See it all now
at thenewedgestudio.com.
Wow, this is VOBS? VOBS is still on?
In a world of audio, two men knew what they were doing, or at least they have you convinced. They put the BS in VOBS.tv.
VoiceOver Body Shop. Learn the latest in voiceover technology. Learn how to get rid of that. VoiceOver Body Shop, 9 Eastern, 6 Pacific, on VOBS.us.
Okay, we removed
all righty, we're back. And, you know, one of the things that I like to talk about is one of my favorite people in the entire world, and that's Harlan Hogan, or H2, as those of us who are close to him call him. But one of the great things he has is his website, voiceoveressentials.com. Why is it so special? Well, first off, because he's been sponsoring us, if you can believe this, for 6 years now. When we get to VoiceOver Atlanta, George and I will be celebrating our 6th year of doing this show together and getting you all this information. And Harlan has been there every step of the way, letting you know the great products that he has. Like tonight, I'm using the VO1A, this particular microphone here, which is custom designed by Harlan himself. He says, I want a microphone that's going to be right for voiceover. And he went to the people at MXL, and they designed with him this marvelous microphone that is at a great price point. And the place you can get it is at voiceoveressentials.com. Go to that page, Andrew. Oh, nicely done. You can see the other products that he has here, like the headphones and the porta booth and all these other things that are just flickering around here. The porta booth, the porta booth plus, the porta booth pro. He also sells other things. You can see there's a mic mate there. Oh, it's over here. I'm getting confused. The mic mate and all the other great things that he has, especially his signature series collection of the microphone, the headphones, the Harlan Hogan headphones that are really great because they're very flat and extremely well designed, and they'll last a long time as well. Go over to voiceoveressentials.com, buy his stuff, go through the website, really see all of the magnificent things that he has to offer there, along with books and various other things that'll help you educate yourself and make your voiceover business better. It's voiceoveressentials.com. You want to go there real easily? Right after the show, stay on our page, but go down to the bottom and click on the picture of Harlan, and it will take you right there to voiceoveressentials.com. Look over this great catalog of stuff he has. And most importantly, he stands behind his stuff. If you don't like it, you can send it back, but you're going to love it anyway. Thanks, Harlan. We'll be back with Robert Marshall, right after this.
Before time began, there was VOBS.TV. Watch or else.
You're competing for work with other voice talents, and every one of them has a powerful, unique, engaging voice demo. Your voice demo needs to stand out from the crowd in an unforgettable way. Now it can. Vizzy Visual Voice Demos take your awesome voice demo and add a visual element, reinforcing your brand. Your demo will leave a lasting impression because it stimulates two senses instead of just one. Your voice is your livelihood. You need an effective demo to open doors of opportunity. Blow those doors down with a Vizzy Visual Voice Demo. Visit VizzyDemos.com for more information. Your audio demo never looked so good. Take your voice demos to the next level, a visual level, with Vizzy Visual Voice Demos. Check out our introductory pricing at VO Atlanta 2017.
Thanks, Dad.
All right, we're back with Robert Marshall from Source Elements, and George is there in Boulder, squeezing every last inch out of the internet that he can. It's everywhere. I mean, back and forth and back and forth and in and out and all that kind of stuff.
I'm using Verizon's unlimited LTE to do the show tonight. I am so glad they announced unlimited LTE. I'm absolutely taking advantage of it tonight.
Yeah, we all know what happened when we were at WovoCon last year and we couldn't get good internet, so we used my phone. Boy, my wife was just thrilled when we saw the data bill at the end of that month. That was really something. Anyway, we've got some great questions tonight from our audience out there in internet land. Anthony first has a question. He says, first, huge kudos on a fantastic product. It's been crucial to the growth of his voiceover business. Please come to WovoCon so I can buy you a beer. Okay. My question, do you see any common trends among the voice talents using Source Connect that might help newcomers use Source Connect to build their business? P.S. Have you seen my YouTube video on firewall configuration for Source Connect? Mute. He's unmuted.
I will unmute Robert because we want to hear him. Sorry. Go ahead, Robert.
Oh, I said I've not seen the video, but send a link. Would love to see the video on the firewall configuration. So things that talent have been doing with Source Connect. I'm sorry, Dan. Can you reread that part of the question?
Sure. It says, do you see any common trends among voice talents using Source Connect that might help newcomers to the voiceover business use Source Connect to build their businesses?
One trend is that we've introduced the subscription service. So it makes the price point of entry a lot lower, a lot easier to get into. That's one thing. And the new Source Stream service, I think takes pretty much the last big hurdle of the technical setup out of it. So it's really easy to set up. I mean, what are people doing that makes
could dovetail on that. I don't know if this exactly is what Anthony is talking about, but because it's now a subscription service, you can get a new user. You can get one of those studios that maybe was on ISDN or maybe never they had something like this, and you can kind of, it might be easier to convince them to try using Source Connect because of a lower barrier to entry, which could then help create a new way that you work with a studio. It's really interesting because at the higher echelon of things, the higher pay scale, union, whatever, generally the studio, the producer, production, they determine how the job's going to go down. Here's what we're using. Here's when you're connecting, period. At the lower end of things, you as talent have more power over the session because they tend to not know what's capable of doing, what's possible sometimes, and to give them new tools to use that may not cost them much to use. I don't know. That could be another way that you may not have thought about building a new connection or a new lead or just
strengthening
what you already have.
Here's something else I've noticed many times. We have our own bridging service that we provide, and
I was turning on the.
I can't tell you. First of all, the funniest bridge I ever did.
Isn't that yours?
Was an unnamed service. It was IPDTL. It was IPDTL to ISDN to ISDN bridge to Source Connect. Because no one calls each other to see what tools they should really use, and no one wants to basically say, okay. The studio producers are just like, okay, book at ISDN, and the talent has Source Connect, and the studio has Source Connect too, and the talent never says, hey, do you guys have Source Connect? Because we could do that directly. So it just ends up getting booked in the most inefficient way possible because no one really asks. And what I've found really is that most studios have both Source Connect and ISDN, and so I see so many bridges happening that are truly unnecessary. Happens more often than I'd like to admit. It's sort of, and that's one thing that's kind of an advice. I don't know if that's a new trend, but it's really just if you have Source Connect, don't be afraid to ask your clients, hey, can we do this over Source Connect? And don't just use it as a bridging tool because that's really the sort of the bluntest way to use it in a sense. It's best to use direct.
Don't assume they don't have it.
Because they probably do have it, actually.
They probably do have it more often than not because they've needed to have it because they've needed a backup for their ISDN. And they've needed a way to connect to more talent. So chances are they probably do. This one's another question from Paul Stefano kind of dovetails onto that nicely, which kind of is about interoperability. And, is there any hopes of interoperability between your technology and some of the others out there, like IPDTL? Do you see that as a possible future development?
So I can say that there's definitely, I guess, some possibilities. It's really a hard thing to answer, I guess. Specifically with IPDTL, that I don't know. That would be big melding of minds and databases and user bases. Certainly, Source Connect now and IPDTL are both using Chrome. So, from a core technology point of view, I guess there shouldn't be. I mean, really, in their core, they're using the exact same back end of Chrome. So that's not the issue. This is more of like a phone directory issue and things like that. And I couldn't really say. There's so many other tools out there that really one of the things that makes it easy to use is not trying to the interoperability creates a huge amount of you have to really know what you're doing to achieve that interoperability, and so that's where it's much easier to create your own sandbox that works really well with your own systems, and that's where you have a much better customer experience when you're able to control both sides of the connection. And trying to create that interoperability creates so many variables that it's harder. It's much harder to do, certainly.
Sure.
So, are we going to be able to do it? I don't know. I think there's definitely the possibility of it happening. but we're always keen to, you know, certainly keep our side nice and clean and make everything work really well there. And so is it worth doing if it's really complex is the question.
Yeah. Got a question here from Reen Vogel, and she asks, why would a voiceover talent want Source Connect Standard versus Source Connect Pro? And both of those are just a one-time fee, correct?
Yeah, so Source Connect Standard you can get as a subscription or as a one-time fee. Source Connect Pro is available as a one-time fee or technically a rent-to-own as well. And there's probably not too many situations where a voice talent would want Source Connect Pro. Especially, you know, if what we're talking about is working on, you know, spots, you know, broadcast type work. And if you're not doing really high-end music recording or ADR for a big film, you know, like all these situations, everyone was perfectly happy with the audio that was coming down the line from ISDN. And Source Connect Standard is going to sound better than ISDN already. It's true that Source Connect Pro's got higher bit rates and some other features that can make it sound a little bit better. But I think the true reality is that only your dog might hear the difference. And so there, you know, what feature would be necessary in Standard for or in Pro for a voice talent? Possibly the VPN mode. Sorry?
VPN mode. Oh yeah, the VPN mode. Could save somebody's butt someday.
Yeah, you can get through practically any firewall, but you would, you know, you'd have to have a big VPN set up, and you'd have to get it all set up. So while you could travel and have this, you know, VPN mode all set up, chances are there's not too many people that are really going to get that all done. If it's not a really dedicated point-to-point situation, you know, VPN mode was more envisioned for these big studios that have just ultimate security in mind, and there's no way that they can travel the public internet and not have everything be incredibly encrypted.
VPN stands for a virtual private network.
Right.
That is a tool that's used more commonly now, more commonly all the time now with security issues on the internet. So it is being used more often. Mike Martin asked another question that, again, sort of dovetails off that, because he was asking about trying to understand the three versions. So that kind of separates Standard and Pro. Standard is sort of a somewhat stripped down, more user-friendly version of Pro. Doesn't have quite as much under the hood bells and whistles and switches that you can control.
Yeah, like, you know, Pro, you can control the forward error correction, or what's listed as the resilience of the connection. You can discreetly control your buffer in very fine increments. You can set your bit rate in also very fine increments and go higher up on the scale. You know, so Standard's got like, you know, four or five buffer settings. It's got three quality settings. It's just easier to understand, has exactly what you need, and doesn't have, but really the primary difference, you know, for instance, the reason why Pro is useful on the studio side is, one thing, it's capable of networking multiple connections in simultaneously. I don't think there's too many voice talent that need to do that. But on the studio side, you could have a connection where you got one guy, you're in Chicago, I've done this, you're in Chicago, recording a guy in New York, and you got recording another guy in LA, you're cross-patching them to each other, they're acting, you know, against each other, and you're recording them both completely separately into your system. So that's something you need for Pro. Pro has the full ability to use the restore and replace system. So Source Connect Standard can feed replacement data. But if you're not on the recording side and you're only feeding your voice to somebody else, you have no need for that ability to do the replacement. That's the recording side that needs to do that. So that's another feature that's in the Pro version. And Standard has the half of that feature that's necessary for the guy in the Pro side to make use of it. The same thing goes with the transport locking system. So on the Pro side, they can. It's very useful for doing ADR for movies. On the Standard side, the feature for the transport lock that's in there is mainly intended so that the voice talent can look at picture, read to picture sync, and the studio side receives that perfectly in sync with their picture and their timeline. So really, you know, it's like, what are the features that the talent needs? And that's what Standard has. And what are the features that the studio needs to be able to do all this recording and receive all this data? And that's the the bigger pile of features that the pro has to you know, for the engineers on that side to do their job. I really, it was really designed where there shouldn't be too many cases for broadcast, TV, radio, industrials, that a talent would need to have the pro version. And, you know, we'd be more than happy to say, hey, get it. But that wouldn't be really from the vision of why standard was put out there and what it's for and really, you know, like why sell somebody more than they need.
Yeah. So the now version is going to be, it's free now and it's going to always have a free version. I understand.
Correct.
That.
Yep.
The only version that you would charge, the only reason you charge for the now version would be for, you know, maybe some more professional features or some ups.
Yeah. So it's probably going to like, we haven't mapped it out exactly, but, so for instance, the ability to conference in multiple connections would probably be a feature. Mm-hmm. We might trim down on some of the bit rates a little bit as well and make that a subscribe feature, because the reality is that, you know, for us to be able to put the free software out there, there has to, it's, you know, it's like Obamacare. Mm-hmm. And some group does have to be paying for the software that's really, you know, the heavier users that need those other features. Right. You know, I'm trying to think of some other features. You know, we have a lot of accoutrements for the talent side, the talkback switches, you know, maybe a built-in recorder and you know, like the ability to, it's not quite in there yet, but the ability to record both sides of the connection so you can
Right.
read what's coming at you. Probably a very big feature that will be on the paid side will be for now to be able to connect into the upper versions of Source Connect. That Right. will almost invariably be a paid feature.
Right, wow. Right. And just to remind you, Maxine is very great at reminding us to say certain things, such as the web address where all this information is.
SourceElements.com, SOURCE-hyphen-minus elements.com. And another, you know, I think someone else asked about, you know, like, why get this service over that service? And one of the views is that, you know, we're a software company, but we're also a service company. And, you know, not to take away from what you do, George, and I think you take it to a whole nother level. So, I mean, just today I was on a tech support call helping somebody out in Africa, actually. And when they all finished up, they you know, were like, can we ask you about Pro Tools? And I'm like, okay, yeah, you got 10 minutes here. Let's go above and beyond. And we really take tech support extremely seriously. And we really pride ourselves on providing, you know, cause we know that you guys are out there doing sessions, and when you need it to work, you need it to work. And so we're, you know, it's software to use, and it's also a service to rely on. And so we try to provide really affordable support fees. You know, it's like you buy the software and then you can have, you know, we encourage you to grab a support contract. So there's an included, with standard 6 months or with pro 1 year. And then after that, you know, you can get support for $105 a year. And if your support contract is uninterrupted, there's no breaks in it, that provides you also any software updates. So in a sense, it's like, you know, software updates with free support or support with free software updates. But we try to make sure that the support fees are very affordable, you know, $100 a year, so that everyone is there and they have a good experience with the software and they're able to, you know, rely on us when they need us, and we're there for them and there for us, et cetera, you know?
Yeah. Well, Robert, it's been great having you on the show, and we lost Rebekah. She had a prior commitment, you know, cause it is tomorrow there. We should have asked for the future. Darn it. But thanks for coming on, and thanks for giving us this this wonderful choice of products, Source Connect, and people should try it. You know, at least try the Source Connect now and see how it can benefit them, and then it can certainly be something that can help them build their business.
Yeah, I think also, you know, Nexus is a wonderful thing. It's affordable, and it really brings a lot of conveniences right into the system, and it's not limited to being used with just Source Connect or Source Connect now. You know, use it with Skype. just ties your system together and makes it easy to integrate.
Absolutely.
Oh, yeah. I mean, there was so many features. I mean, Nexus is like a, like allows you to take a, any software on your computer that has audio and turn it into a plugin to plug into something else. So Nexus is being with all kind, being with, used with all kinds of stuff. It's being used with Skype. It's being used with IPDTL, Source Connect now. I mean, it can be used with anything. It's a really good tool for universal connectivity. So check that out too.
All righty. All right. Well,
thank you guys so much.
Thank you for being with us. All right. George and I will be back to wrap things up from two different points right after this message.
Learning never ends.
You continue to grow.
Edge Studio has grown. Pursue multiple disciplines in tandem and grow your career. We've added new courses in a new curriculum.
We picked the best coaches from the community of working voice actors.
A new technology division, engineering and consulting, led by George Whittam.
Follow your dream.
Sign up for advanced learning or register for an introduction to voice acting or foundation studies program.
See it all now
at thenewedgestudio.com.
Before time began, there was VOBS.TV. Watch or else.
Having dinner tonight? How about having some VO too?
VoiceOver Body Shop.
Have some voiceover with your dinner tonight on VoiceOver Body Shop, 9 Eastern, 6 Pacific.
And we are back from our 2 points, George and Boulder tonight, me still in my garage where I have this wonderful view. Most people should have a garage like this. Anyway, our thanks again to Robert Marshall and Rebekah Wilson from Source Elements. You know, next week on the show, know who we've got? Anthony Mendez.
Yeah.
Now, there's a great, now he's a great guy. When he was here with us last time, he was talking about this new show he was doing, Jane the Virgin. Boy, my wife and I started binge watching that. Great show. And he makes... he really is one of the key parts of that show. So we're
looking,
now, I don't know if he's going to be here or if he's still going to be in New York, but it doesn't matter. It's always great talking to him.
Remoting in from the East Coast, I would imagine.
Who are our donors of the week?
Donors of the week. We need a theme song. Donors of the week. Donors of the week. Something like that. Something cheesy. Michael Martin. Thank you, Michael. Diana Birdsall. These guys are all subscribers. They send in donations automatically every single month. Eric Aragoni, still not missing an episode. Thank you, Eric.
You rock, Eric.
Thank you, man. Patty Gibbons. Another one came in from... Sometimes it shows me the wrong thing. George Whittam. Thanks, Dad. Still making donations. Thank you, Dad. You haven't figured out how to cancel the donations, have you, Dad? Amanda Fellows and Brian Page. Those are the ones since last week, I believe. So thank you, everybody who's donated to the show to give us a little extra booster so that we have money to pay Andrew, our technical director, producer, and find better tools.
Did a great job tonight. Great job tonight. By the way, you can also get VOBS logo stuff on anything. There's this banner above us here. Just click on it that says, you know, buy logo gear, anything. Great stuff. You at least want to get yourself a coffee mug, you know.
It's a good coffee mug. I drink coffee.
It's a great coffee mug.
Every day.
Or two or five. Get a whole play setting. Let's see what's going on at Edge.
What's going on at Edge? Right now, over at Edge Studio, we are promoting, and I had it here and then I lost it, Edge Studio. What's going on, Edge? Come on now, show me that email. Show me that beautiful beam footage. We have a great newsletter. It's called V Opportunities or Vopportunities. And what's going on? Well, I got my ask a question, get an answer for $19. So just ask me a short sort of tweet-long question, and I'll give you a nice quick answer. But it's a great way to get that nagging question that's been annoying you and get it answered quickly. I turn those around usually within a day or two. It says 5 days, but they're so easy for me to answer that I'm usually much quicker than that on the return. And then we've got HISS, which is the Home Studio Support Squad. It's on-demand remote tech support. I want a flat rate for $79. So if you've got a buzz in your mic, one of our tech support team can help you out and troubleshoot it for you. Again, at one low rate. And if you've got a time-sensitive issue for $159, we'll turn that around much, much more quickly, usually under 4 hours and sometimes a lot faster. So that's some of the things going on. We also have something I haven't mentioned on the show before, and that is we also at Edge have VOPR consults. So Suzanne Pinedo at Edge can help you with PR issues. So you've been trying to learn how to better network and build your business and deal with PR sides of things. She's someone that can help you out.
All righty. Yeah. Let's see. Show logs, you know where you can get those. They're right up there. You know you can watch us on, you can listen to the podcast in case you can't watch us for some reason, even though you should make every effort every week to watch us live. But if you can't, we're on YouTube. You can also watch the podcast or listen to the podcast over at Stitcher Radio, iTunes, ewebs.podbean.com, all those places you can get those kinds of things.
Just a reminder, all the podcast listeners that only listen to it, if you ever want to see it live and be in that chat room, that's Monday nights at 6 p.m. Pacific time.
That's right.
I sometimes have to remind myself that, you know, a lot of the people that consume the show never have tuned in. They just found us online and they're subscribing. So if you ever want to see us, what we do, and be able to interact in the chat room, that's where you go to check it out. VOBS.TV at 6 p.m. Pacific time, Monday night.
Yeah. DawView 2017 probably makes very little sense to them if they're listening in their car. Let's see. Take the survey, which is also up there. We'd like to hear what you guys want on the show. And if you want to be in our actual studio like George's parents are tonight, wave,
George,
guys.
George and Mary. Hello, wake up. You're on.
You can use the better audience cam, actually. Okay. There's the better audience cam. All right. Thanks for being here tonight, guys. It's always great to have an audience here. If you want to be in the audience, let us know. Write to us at theguys@vobs.tv if you're going to be here in the greater Los Angeles area, especially if you're in the Valley, because it's a lot easier to get here. And let us know that you want to be here, and I'll say, who are you? Give us 6 references, and we'll let you in here and bring food. Time to thank our sponsors, Vizzy Video Demos.
Harlan Hogan.
Voiceover Extra.
Voiceover Central. Voiceover Extra. Edge Studio.
Source Elements.
VO2GoGo and the Rehearsal app.
And finally, Antland's Killer Demos. All you guys, thank you for providing the uninterrupted stream that you get to see here every Monday night. Thanks to Marcy, who's in Florida this week. So she doesn't really know what we're doing out here. Catherine Curden, our great producer. Anthony Gettig for his great work in the chat room tonight. And, of course, our amazing floor director, Andrew Bushwitz. All right. And Jack DeGolia for the show notes. And our good friend Lee Penny, simply for being Lee Penny. Lee, come down and visit us. All right. That's going to do us for us tonight. There is a short mug man right after this show. Do not go away. You want to watch this, see what Jacob's been up to. That's going to do it for us. I'm Dan Leonard.
I'm George Whittam.
And this is VoiceOver.
Body Shop.
Or VOBS.
Yeah.
All right. Have a great week, everybody. Anthony Mendez next week. We'll see you then.
Flavor.